This is SCP Radio Network, coming to you live from Skylab Studios. Up next is LypStk Live with your host, Lady Franchelle.
What's up? It's your girl, Lady Franchelle, coming to you live from Skylab Studios.
With the LypStk Candy Girls.
The show made for women by women.
And jamming those banging ass beats, DJ Jimmy Ray and Light Jockey Mike.
So get ready for another edition of
LypStk Live, baby,
here on SCP Radio.
It's that time again. It is LypStk Live. It is Thursday. You must know it's Thursday because you're live with us here with the ladies taking in charge. Yesterday, of course, we had the cave show with the guys. Sit back, relax, kick the feet up, and drink the beer. But tonight, the ladies, they're out of the kitchen. They threw down their apron, and they're ready to do it live. Yes. Here only on LypStk Live. And here's one of your hosts, Lady Frangio. Take it away, girl.
Ooh, somebody need to get them some more toys. Hold on, we got some. Ooh, you know what? This is me. Why am I doing that? Why would my phone do that? Anyway.
Oh yeah.
What's up, everybody? It's ladies' night here at Skylab Studios, and this is LypStk Live. I'm your girl, Lady Franchelle, here with the LypStk Candy Girls, Tasha T, Nikki, and of course, the boss. Also in the studio, DJ Jimmy Ray on the ones and twos.
Oh, yeah.
And manning the cameras is Light Jockey Mike. What's up, Mike?
What's up?
So, if no one read our Facebook page, we're streaming live. You can actually see us live if you go to scpradio.com. You can actually see us talking, doing our thing. There's that laughing. Ladies, how was your weekend?
Look at him.
That's not us.
You're on TV.
Way.
Okay, DJ Fluffy in the house. Ladies, how was your weekend? I think this weekend was a drier weekend than previous.
Weather was nice.
It was nice. Okay, but before we get started, we want to go ahead and thank everyone for visiting our Facebook and Instagram pages. We want to welcome our new listeners. And if you are interested in any topic that we're going to speak about today, you can join in on the talk by calling us at 832-910-7727 or log on to
scpradio.com.
I knew that. scpradio.com. You can go and visit and talk with us in the chat room or just watch us stream live as the show goes on.
I just raised my body temperature like 7 degrees.
Okay. Got a little drinks in the house. So we got a lot to talk about today. So everybody's ready?
Yeah, ready.
Okay, but before we get started, of course, I have to say the comments and or opinions expressed here on LypStk Live are not those of SCP Radio or its affiliate station. It's just our personal opinions. So if you have a problem with anything we say, too bad.
Got too bad. Him.
Okay. That's a good one you got. Okay, y'all. We already know what the big topic in the news is. Miss Caitlin. What is it?
It's Miss.
Okay. Yes. How is it Miss when you still have a dangling?
How many people with a dangling do you know deserve to be called Miss? A lot of them.
That's a good one.
So that's what I want to know. So if I wake up tomorrow and I say I'm feeling a little boyish and I dress up like a boy, am I a boy that day?
If that's what you want to be categorized as or prefer to be called as.
Right.
I'm a boy for that day?
Well, no.
Well, I mean, how many times do I need to dress up like a boy before you call me a boy?
It's not dressing up like a boy. I feel like it's more of how you feel yourself. Mm-hmm. What gender do you identify with most?
Okay, so do you girls agree that transgender is a legitimate, what do we call it? A disorder or
a legit thing. Just call it a thing.
It's just a thing. It's a thing we're still learning about.
I think that
still learning.
Yeah, we all still learning about
okay,
it.
Okay, so how did y'all feel when Caitlyn came out with her Vanity Fair spread?
Yes, bitch.
I was like,
yes.
Wow, she looks nice.
Okay, yeah. Do y'all really think she looked like that, or was they really playing with the Photoshop button?
Mm-mm. No, that's her.
Well, they Photoshop everything, though. Some things possibly were Photoshop, but for the most part, it looks just like Caitlyn looks like Bruce.
You know what?
Right. No, I know what you mean.
You know what I mean?
Right.
You can like still Bruce. See, like, he's hard in the face, like a man, you know.
But and, you know who?
But then in some places it's smooth like a woman.
Just you know what I'm saying? The angles that they use and stuff. I mean,
I believe it's Photoshop because I have video. I'm sorry. I have video. I'm not talking about video of her on that shoot where she's already painted up. I'm talking about video of her driving around Malibu.
Well, yeah, she's an ugly woman.
That's everybody. Come
that's
on.
Most women.
Yes. Really?
Women out there really? With our all makeup on and
so,
everything.
So, basically, y'all willing to concede that a man can wake up one day and look better than all us bitches?
Yeah, but he...
Does he look better than all those bitches?
Well, no, I don't know about all that. I don't know about all that.
Okay.
There are some. What is King Amaya? Is that his well, name? His or her name?
Who?
King Amaya? Amaya?
Who is that?
The boy that turned into the girl.
Well, I'm going to tell Amaya y'all who's my favorite transgender.
RuPaul?
RuPaul's good. She old school. Let me tell you who's my favorite transgender. Laverne from
right, Laverne Cox
is the new black.
Laverne Cox, but you know who passes for a woman better than any? What is this girl's name? The girl that lied on Chingy.
Oh, I don't know her name, but Chingy. I do know who you talking
is it
about.
A her?
She, no, let me tell you something. If you didn't know, you wouldn't know. And I'm telling you right now, if you didn't know, you wouldn't know.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she passes in a way
that so,
you can't even believe.
A lot of people had problems with everyone saying that Caitlyn, a.k.a. Bruce, was courageous for coming out and sharing her transformation with the whole world. So do y'all think that's courageous or some kind of Kardashian publicity stunt?
Not a stunt.
I don't think it was.
I mean, was it done for attention or was it real?
It's more accepting. Like being gay, being transgender these days is more accepting than it was back then. Uh-huh. Probably when he wanted to come out when he was younger, mm-hmm. nobody would have accepted him. So I guess in the essence from they're saying he was courageous. Yeah, 20, 30 years ago, I might have looked at it as being courageous, but now today it's more common than a lot
right,
of people.
Right, not so taboo.
Yeah, it's not.
Now I feel like it's always courageous when you take a hold of your own life and live it unapologetically mm-hmm. the way you want to.
Mm-hmm.
That's for anything. Now I wouldn't say he deserves an award like they're giving him an award for it.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't feel like. Not to minimize what he did, because I'm all for it, but I just don't feel like it's an act that you need an award for, because there are other things that I feel like the guy, the double amputee, right. that's a runner. I think something like that, those awards are for things like that.
Talking about awards, I read something on Facebook saying that they want to take his awards that he won when he was an athlete because he was a male and he wasn't sure that he was supposed to have been a woman, so... Like the gender wasn't
He's still
I know, but they're trying to debate that and trying to take away his awards now. So.
Do you think he would give a damn?
He already did.
He was on the
Wheaties. I know.
He had a man when he won. He was already on the Wheaties box. So what the fuck?
But I did.
You want
read
to go back and put a dress on the Wheaties box? What the hell?
No, I did read how I did read how people wanted to know whether he was going to be taken off the Wheaties series. And Wheaties said, General Mills, Wheaties said, no, he'll always be part of the family. He's a man, Bruce, Caitlin, whoever he is.
Yeah.
He's, I mean, no, when it has nothing to do with what's going on now.
And he looks like Jessica Lange.
Yeah. Yes. He looks better than his ex-wife.
He looks like Jessica Lange. I know I'm not crazy.
No, he does. Did you see the comparison, friend?
I see the comparison.
Yeah, they had a picture on Facebook comparing the two.
I saw the
comparison.
He looks just like it to me.
That chin. Something about that hard ass chin.
Because she has that chin. Square jawline, just like a man.
Like a man.
So
you're looking like a man.
So when you become a Caitlin, are you gay? No. Are you lesbian?
Well, yeah.
What are you?
You still got a wiener.
I like a woman.
You see, I'm going to tell you. You're living as a woman. Wait.
Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, go. It's on you, Nikki.
Go ahead, Nikki.
Feel like.
If you're Caitlin, what you going to date? Man or woman?
I'm going to date whatever my sexual preference is. I don't think his sexual preference changes because his gender changes. And
so he's a lesbian. So he still likes gal.
At this point, lesbian.
Yeah. I mean, hey, he can still hit that rod on him. Get him
so he got some extra.
I'm just saying.
Something for you to grab onto.
Oh, Lord.
I grabbed a couple of them. That's something to grab onto. You're right. I'm just like, he likes women as a man. He is, even through his transition, he says he still likes women. Uh-huh. So I don't think, like, some people confuse the gender confusion with your sexuality. I think they're two different things.
You believe that?
Yeah.
Well, I'm just confused as, okay, you made a decision to still be a man but look like a woman and still be attracted to women. What is this other woman that you attract? Like, if someone decides to date Caitlin, what is her sexuality at that time?
Yeah.
As long as he has his wiener, she's straight. When he gets his cup, he's gay. I mean, I don't know.
Yeah.
That's
the most confusing part to me. Like, all my life, I thought I liked men, and now I like you, and you're a woman.
Yeah, but
that,
I mean,
so but am I gay? Really, I mean, I don't know. Because that's when you know their relationship is far beyond sex.
Yeah.
By the way, Dennis Rodman said he want to go on a date with
I was
him.
Just about to
oh
say.
My God.
He's already got a date lined up with Dennis
man,
Rodman.
Man, woman, or both. I would not go out with Dennis fucking Rodman.
Why? He looked like he kind of freaky.
And he looked nasty. Dennis Rodman. Let me tell you something. Dennis Rodman looked like you need a tetanus shot after you deal with him.
Yeah.
You look like you got to wash him up before we get that one. Hold on, baby.
Wash him up in what? Bleach?
Okay. Through the damn car wash.
He need a little beef bleach scrub or something before you deal with that. Ugh.
Damn.
That's disgusting.
Back in the day, he was the freakiest thing going on. Put on a dress for you and everything.
I don't want that.
Oh.
I want my man to look like a man.
Oh,
and I don't want him going over to China.
And we're not gonna sit in their shop, and you're gonna get your toes polished.
Talking about putting a dress on. Did y'all see Jaden Smith?
I'm so tired of him.
That wasn't a dress, was it? Was it a skirt?
Yes, it was a dress.
It was a long shirt. But my problem, that's not even a problem. The problem is what he wore to his own fucking prom.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
No, that was somebody else's prom. Oh. He wore an all-white Batman superhero costume to his prom with a blazer on top of the motherfucker.
What?
Those kids are weird.
Okay, to the
that's
point,
what
like, it's ridiculous.
That's what money do to you.
No. Those kids are crazy, and I think they're trying. What I think they're doing is trying too hard to differentiate themselves to the point where it's ridiculous.
Yeah.
They when you ask them questions in interviews, and they respond with like a series of numbers. Like, you never seen that?
No.
I saw an interview when they were asking them questions, and they would respond like, the birds in the sky, 7374. Like, what the fuck? Like, are you famous or are you crazy? Like, you need the, you can't, what the hell?
They mama crazy. She's
what is
old
she
as hell in a rock band. What's wrong
with
your
question?
What did she do to her face?
I want to know the same thing.
What did she do to her face? Y'all seen Jada Pinkett?
I haven't seen the lady. What
she did something to her face. I don't know. She did something to her face.
What?
I know
some Botox?
It's more than that. Her cheekbones are really, Botox. Really high now. Like her.
She might have got a little skinny, little nipped up.
She picked up a little weight, but her face, she did something. Cool. She's on the new show.
She's on TV.
She's on the new show.
You don't see all them crow's feet.
She's done something to her face.
She's 44. She, you know, you don't want to see all them crow's feet. But we didn't got off of Caitlyn's ass.
I know.
Okay. So
that's not the newest picture of her.
No, that's old.
New.
Yeah, that is old. That's
how she
look.
She got some. Some. Google a picture of her
going
now.
Going down.
Yeah, she getting
younger on us.
That's Jada, old.
Jada got many.
Her new face is stronger than Superman.
Yeah, it's hard.
It's stronger than Superman.
I don't even watch anything on WB. If
it's on Fox.
Oh, yeah, it is. What is it? Gotham?
Because she's bigger than that,
younger
too, now.
Day.
I know, right? That's old, Jada.
Damn, she didn't change from that cover.
That new Jada, she has a pretty strong face.
Okay, anyway, the religious people are chiming in on Caitlyn's transformation, and they feel like the public's acceptance of her transformation is like a sign of Sodom and Gomorrah, the end of the world, the deterioration of the morality in this country. Mm-hmm. What do y'all think? Mike Huckabee said something ugly, and he had to take that off of Facebook because he went off on her.
What did Mike Huckabee? And then he's running for president.
He's running for president. That's why he said, "Oops, let me take this off."
Oops, let me take
screenshot.
She got 1.5 million followers. I'm gonna take this off
and live for the day.
I mean, does this violate any type of morality?
No
issue that you guys. I mean,
with his transition,
is he going? Is she going to hell?
No,
I don't have a heaven or hell to send her to. I
feel like if you're gonna fault him for getting breast implants, every woman, why is it okay for women to have breast implants? That's not what you were born with.
Yeah,
what is your because you,
yeah, because he's dressing and now he's trying to take on the parts of a female, so he's not going to hell. Well, speaking of going to hell. Nikki got into a serious. Oh, I'm sorry. Nikki got
trying into, hard not to. I swear.
Nikki got into a spirited debate with one of her Facebook followers, friends. I happen to be Facebook stalking. I mean, I happen to be scrolling through Facebook and saw that she referred to the Bible. You know what? I don't want to misquote you. You refer to the Bible as what?
The Bible is a man-written book. Just like laws, just like everything else, it evolves over time to fit the needs of society. Not until the King James Version was homosexuality said to be an abomination.
That's what I was going to ask. So are we talking about the King James Version or the Old Testament? What are we talking about?
It's in the Old Testament where it says this. That. Okay, so.
Okay, what's so man-made about it?
A man wrote it.
The Bible wasn't written.
Right, it's man written.
But I thought they copied out the scroll.
No. Who wrote the scroll?
A man wrote it. A man chipped that shit into the scroll with a hammer and a, you know.
Like, okay, so basically the Bible is a man-made, Bible. You go to church and pastor, he interprets it.
Interprets it according to their own.
But you're supposed to listen to the pastor.
That's something that somebody taught you, just like he's only doing what somebody taught him.
So so we're not supposed to believe what the pastor of a church
you can believe whatever you want to believe.
Bam. I'm not
okay. Well, so when you got into this heated debate, you posed the question first. So then he's a regular attendee of church, felt like your comments or your questioning of the Bible may have bordered atheism.
I never said I didn't believe in God or Jesus. I said I did not believe everything in the Bible. No! I'm not going to say that everything in the Bible is wrong, because just as much as I believe in God and Jesus, I do believe there are prophets. Parts of the Bible were written by prophets. The book of Revelation, is no way somebody could have written that 2 centuries ago and then know what's going to happen today. A prophet wrote that portion of the Bible. Just like as the Bible, as people, everyone has made different contributions into the Bible, I feel. Like, who can say, I was there, I saw you? I mean, you're not the guy from CNN. You can't be like, oh, I was there. Like, you weren't. What the fuck? I mean, what in the hell? Like, you weren't there.
So exactly what was his problem with what you said?
Basically, they feel like you need to just live by the word. And then when they say, you say, well, I don't understand this part. They want you to say, well, oh, it's not for you to understand.
Yeah, just keep
well, when
going.
You go to school and you tell your teacher, and they have a textbook there, and they teach you this out of the textbook, you say, I don't understand anything. I'm going to say, oh, it's not for you to understand how this math problem works. You can't teach me with a textbook that you can't decipher.
So you're not going to follow.
They tell you to have faith.
Yeah, you're not going to follow blindly.
Like what?
No. In Jesus, it's faith. No. That's what it's called. It's faith. So you're not going to. You y'all know the hymn. He walked by.
I'm not saying I don't have faith in Jesus or God.
Okay.
What I am saying is that a man wrote the Bible, and everything, like, there are different.
And because a man wrote the Bible, we're not supposed to.
I'm not saying what anybody is supposed to do. I'm just telling you what I do. Uh-huh. I'm not gonna. That's what that is I feel like as people see things they think are undesirable in society or things like that. Over the centuries, what they've done is gone in and added certain things and added more things. Also, you can't, I feel like that's what's happened. Like, as years have gone by, the Bible has evolved and things have happened. People never touch on anything. Like, if you're going by the Bible, then why the hell we celebrate Christmas, Jesus' birthday in December? Jesus was born in the summer. Like, what the hell? Yeah, and everything.
We're not changing Christmas.
I'm not saying change.
Exactly.
Because I like the days off.
Have you always felt this way, Nikki? Or is it the more hypocrites you see?
As a kid, I did not feel this way because I went by what I was taught. And that as a grown person who can look at things for themselves and see how contradictory the Bible is of itself and of reality in different times, I came to this conclusion. Everybody lean on the Bible for all they understanding. How many people in this room believe in dinosaurs? That dinosaurs ever walked the earth? Put your hands up if you believe it. How many people in this room believe that dinosaurs ever walked the earth?
Well, there's proof.
Okay, right.
I ain't seen no damn dinosaur.
But at what point in the Bible do they mention dinosaurs?
Never.
Bam. In the beginning, God created heaven and earth. And where the dinosaurs come in and at?
They forgot them.
Right. They're not in the Bible anyway. But that's okay. You can go ahead and go by the Bible. Okay, if Adam and Eve were the first two people on earth and everybody came from them, how do you explain different races of people?
Yeah.
If Adam and Eve were the first two people on earth, how do you explain different races of people? Different religions, different cultures, I could understand, but how do you explain different races of people?
What you talking about, Nikki?
No, I'm just playing.
So this is what I'm saying.
We're all related.
I think DJ Fluffy has got the spirit.
Okay. I want to touch on a little bit of what Tasha T was about to get into. When she asked you why were you questioning certain things?
Oh.
Was it a certain experience or what? Okay, me myself. Being around people who are in the front row of the pulpit claim to be damn near buddies with Jesus himself.
Holy rollers.
Those people make, to me, doubters. They make me a doubter because how are you going to be standing beside me? You
saw it.
It's funny. You gotta
I'm
watch
sorry.
Everything you do now.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to do
they
that.
They look funny. So the holy rollers in the front row are the main ones that are gonna be sitting next to you talking about, girl, damn, look at him, that nigga show. You know, they cussing more than you.
My grandmother's literally in church said, sit the fuck down in church. And then she's the usher. She's at the door and she's across the room like this. Like you threaten, you telling me you'll beat the shit out of me in church. I won't beat the shit out of in church.
So my thing is, those are the same people who are telling you, Nikki, that you wrong. You know you wrong. You know you shouldn't be saying that. But I can catch them down the street at the hole in the wall, throwing down some shots.
Baby, I know.
Messing over their husband and everything. So that kind of, you know, turns me off about organized religion. When I was brought up in the church, when I was young, every weekend, went to Sunnyside, went to church. But when I saw all that going on, shoot, when I was growing up, I ain't going back there. There's more going on in the church than I hear.
It does. It does deter you from church. I mean, we couldn't miss a Sunday in church. Yeah. I was in the choir. I can't even sing. My grandma made me be in the choir. I was a praise dancer. I could not hit a note for nothing.
I have memorized all Easter speeches when you were ever
okay. Remember them little Easter speeches?
And I used to wear gloves to church, pantyhose, a fucking petticoat. It don't matter if it's 1,000 degrees outside. Got a pantyhose and a petticoat like it's 1863.
Did you wear stockings or a couple socks?
Both. Stockings, and then a pair of ruffle socks on top.
On top of the socks.
When my grandmother went to get her curl done on a Saturday, it was a lady in there selling socks on Saturday. I wore them on Sunday.
Oh, girl, calm
down. Woo! And so I'm telling you, we grew up very devout, old Southern Baptist. Yeah. Like, we grew up like that. And I mean, it's nothing wrong with that. I feel like your religion, that gives you something to hang on to. That's your faith.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And I feel like I'm not going to say that I'm more spiritual than religious. That's what I think. I'm more spiritual than religious.
Me too. I feel like being spiritual is next to godliness, then. boss, you kind of quiet over there.
No, I believe the same thing. I don't think that you have to be in church every Sunday to be blessed or to have God or, you know, watch over you or anything like that. If you believe in something, that something's going to be with you all the time. So.
Well, you know, they say that the building is just a building. The church is within you.
Exactly.
So,
and like you said, there's a lot of hypocrites that go to church.
It's so many. It is. It is almost sickening. I'm like, now how in the hell are you going to sit here and preach to me Ephesians 13, such and such. And I just seen you leave from out that motel and that was not your husband you was with.
Let me tell you this. This is how I feel.
These are
that.
True stories.
This is what I feel. I feel like people can preach the word and still have those tendencies because nobody is perfect. But at the same time, what I don't want you to do, you don't feel like nobody is perfect. So
you can be a church member and you can tell that you can say that or feel that way, but not a preach. No.
I feel like a preacher is there to teach you. They're not teaching you how they living. They're just telling you what the Bible says you should do. Now, whether they choose to live like that or not, that's just like people who teach aeronautics or something like that. Somebody could teach you how to fly a plane. That don't mean they're a pilot. It's people that teach you shit like that that don't know how to do. That's not what they do at all. Somebody could teach you how to fly a plane. Somebody teach you surgery. Yeah, they can. It is like that.
I feel like it's different for me.
You can preach the word to me. I can feel it. But at the same time, I just feel like the Bible, when it comes to certain things, like people pick and choose what they want to get on people about. Because if you go by the Bible, you're not supposed to eat shellfish and you're not supposed to be an overeater. Yeah, it's in the Bible. Mm-hmm. Not supposed to eat shellfish. Not supposed to overeat because then you're a gluttonous. That's one of the seven deadly sins. Not supposed to look at stuff other people have and want it. And this is my problem. Andy. And I'm going to say this because I had this discussion with somebody too. I feel like if God made every single person, why would you give a person a feeling like jealousy and say, oh, you got it, but don't use it? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Why would you make people, and just like this free will thing, everybody say, oh, you have free will. You're going to tell me I had the freedom to do what I want, and then you go on the same breath, you're going to tell me, well, God knows everything you're going to do before you do it. So if God knows what you're going to do before you do it, what's really the point of repenting, of what's free will? All of that. See, all of this come into play with my questions. And so that's what I'm dealing with right now.
But you have to remember the devil was once an angel himself. So everything that you do or do, everything you do or how you feel is not always of God.
Everything, whenever I had this discussion, what people revert to is things that they've been taught out of the Bible.
Yeah, like I said.
So that goes, to me, when people say stuff to me like that, it really don't hold weight because you're just repeating what you learned out of the Bible, which is a book that was written by man. They want nothing. When people don't understand stuff, they want to be able to rationalize it and structure
it.
And
that is their own way.
That is what the Bible is. The Bible is a rationalization for people who really don't,
So where do we get the good people from? Because if we ain't listen, if we don't believe in something, we all gonna. I'm just saying, if we don't believe in something, then we all gonna be some damn devils running around here doing wrong. I mean,
everybody has to have belief. That's
because everybody is born with a moral compass. If nobody ever teach you about Jesus or God, you already born with a moral compass. Yep. You know, right? You know if this is right or this is wrong. Nobody have to tell you. God don't like it for you to know it's wrong. When I was a kid, I knew I'm not supposed to be doing this because she already said don't do this, and I'm doing it anyway. Nobody tell me, oh, God don't like that. You're born with a moral compass. That's the bottom line.
So you don't need a Bible.
I'm not gonna say that. Don't do that.
I'm sorry.
Don't do that, friend.
I'm not saying that myself.
I'm not going to hinge my life on that at this point.
Alone.
I'm just not right on that alone because I feel like the Bible was written by a man and things are like as society goes on, things are added in. Oh, men like men. Well, I don't like the way they look. But how can I get everybody else to agree with me? Let me put that in the Bible and then they're going to believe it because it's in the Bible. Mm-hmm. Because not until, like I said before, and I keep reiterating that, it's things that are not in old Bibles that are in new Bibles. Things that are in new that were there that's not there anymore. That's how it is. So, you know, and then I feel like it's holy books for every religion.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The holy book for each religion is like a manual for like you go to a job, you get a new work manual. Yep. That's what that is. That's something that's written by man because these are rules they want you to follow.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Plain and simple.
So basically you haven't found a job that you like or that you feel
that has that
you're
manual.
Willing to follow. You
I'm going to be unemployed spiritually.
Well, on that note, we're going to take a break. And we're going to pray for Nikki. We'll be right back. Okay, ladies. Everybody, we're back.
We're back.
Ooh, that was a long break. I'm kind of long-winded because he was really jamming. Nikki, you ready?
I'm ready.
Oh, okay, you're going to be on the phone. That's fine. Hey, so did anybody see? Oh, okay.
Lady told him a damn car.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
So did anybody see the story about the four family members who were arrested for beating the 14-year-old girl?
Yes, we.
Okay. In case you hadn't heard the story, Dallas police say four family members have been arrested after a 14-year-old girl impregnated by a relative was beaten in order to induce an abortion 2 years ago.
Wow.
Right.
As opposed to just paying for an abortion?
As opposed to putting her on the pill?
Well, it's not like she asked for him to rape her. Don't put her on the pill.
It appears that four damn people knew she was fucking.
No, she wasn't fucking. One of her cousins raped her, and then that's why they tried to abort the baby because her one
I
of
mean,
the women.
How many times did it happen? I
wasn't. Who knows? Because he was way older than her.
It sounded like this was a long term.
No, it was a family member that raped.
I know
her.
That there was a long. It was going on for a long time, and everybody knew about it.
Well, she was 8 months pregnant when they beat the baby out of her. The baby was 8 months. She was eight months pregnant.
Yeah, in 2013. But it was also reported that they attempted to give her the morning after pill several times. But, of course, she was too far along and nothing happened. So they decided to go to extraordinary means to end this pregnancy by going on an hour-long beating of this 14-year-old in order to induce early labor.
Okay. Which they did when the baby being born stillborn, right?
When the baby was born stillborn.
Oh, wow.
So I'd rather them just allow the girl to finish her pregnancy. She's just a month away. And go take the baby to the fire department.
Well, she said in interview they did with questions and to the police, she said that the lady, one of the ladies involved told her, well, you're not about to get my kids taken from me with this. So they were trying to keep the whole thing a secret. So they didn't even want the baby. They didn't want anybody to know she even had the baby or whatever because they didn't want any questions. Of course, what you're saying
they
is true.
They didn't want them to take their kids away. They had kids. The family members had kids. And so
even if they had kids, you don't have to when you go drop that baby off and at the hospital.
If you let other family members rape me, you don't need no fucking kids.
Exactly. And that probably has been going on in their family.
That's what I was trying to say.
Did you see the guy who did it?
No, I didn't see him.
Y'all think go wait a minute. Now, when you see him, you're like,
is he part of the four that were arrested?
It's five of them. Would you leave your daughter alone with him?
He look like he did top
cross eye corner. Would you leave your kid with this motherfucker?
You mean James Brown? Girl, way too much. I'm not just saying. That's what he looked like, James Brown.
Yeah.
If you broke a car with James Brown.
Leave your baby here.
That's not funny
at all. Get on the good foot.
I'm sorry.
That's not funny at all.
But okay. But it gets even wilder because after
family look retarded.
Okay. Mm-hmm. After they induce the birth and the child was born stillborn, they made some rather crude attempts to get rid of the baby's body.
Mm-hmm.
What in the hell is the matter with people thinking a barbecue pit is a means to get rid of a human body?
They burnt the baby.
They put it on the barbecue pit.
They put it
on
the barbecue.
Wait, is that the one that happened here not too long ago? Or
no, that was a lady who was chopped up.
Yeah.
That was a lady that got chopped up and then he tried to put her body on the barbecue pit.
And they say the smell of that is
a burning flesh.
It just can't be. It cannot be mistaken for no baby back ribs. But anyway, they attempted to burn the body. Of course, a barbecue pit will not get hot enough to disintegrate a body. If you've ever had, if you've ever seen remains from a human being that's being cremated, you can never get rid of everything. Even a little bones, you'll still see little fragments of bones. You cannot just get rid of a body like that. It will not disintegrate. So after
and they
that,
paid them $25 to do the shit.
After that was afterwards. They couldn't do the barbecue. So they gave this man $25 to go take these barbecue remains and put them.
If you
somewhere.
Call them barbecue remains again, I'm not gonna eat everything off the table. You just call them that again.
Without the sauce. But to get rid of the remains for $25. Are y'all going to take a charge for improperly disposing of a body behind $25? What the hell could have gotten for $25?
He accessory to it. Now,
some chicken?
What?
$25.
What?
So anyway, they thought that everybody was in the clear, but they didn't expect young girl, to grow up and have scars from this.
Of course you are. Like, are you crazy?
They didn't care.
Fuck scars. I'm coming back one by one. Every single one of you motherfuckers in your sleep. Every fucking single one of you motherfuckers.
I'm going to wake you up right before I do it.
So who
I'm going to crack your head open. That's how you going to wake
the
up.
The young girl.
Yeah,
I'll cry.
Up and see me.
The young girl.
I will
I'll
be
cry.
The last thing that you remember.
There is no statute of limitations on outcry when you are a young girl. So 2 years later, she outcried to another adult, told them what went on, and it got reported to the police. No statute of limitations.
And it shouldn't
that's
be because these motherfuckers
that's
are crazy.
Good. Yeah, that
but they're not being charged with murder because there's no laws on the books about fetuses. They're getting charged with what? Organized crime? Some other type of charges
to a child
related rape? Yeah, injury to the child related to
her, right?
yeah, related to things done to her. But as for, you know, charges in regards to actually the causing the death of this fetus, the child was born stillborn. Mm. So you can't, and there's no body. Right,
and they can't say, well, this is why the baby was dead or anything.
So the charges that they're going to get charged are related to the beating and or the rape.
Did y'all see, well, let me, I know this is a little off topic, but did y'all see the guy from who's from here and his kids are from Orange? You didn't see that the kids came up to visit the dad from Orange, Texas, and he beat them both behind potty training potty and killed training. One
okay,
of them.
Okay, I seen that. Okay, that he got capital murder for that.
He did. He needed. He needs it.
Let me tell you something. He need to. I would take his head and his motherfucking bald headed ass sister and click that shit together like fucking cartoons. You gotta be fucking kidding me.
Aunt, what does the sister have to do with it?
She didn't stop him. Okay. He, injury. She watched everything that he did. He scalded the young baby.
Yeah. So she was and charged.
The older son.
So she was charged with injury to the child by omission because she actually witnessed and did not intervene or report that a child was being abused.
I will tell my brother.
She probably lied in the initial
report.
I would report. Do his ass like she did that man on Women of Brewster Place. Remember when she said, "If you touch my child again, I'm gonna meet your soul in hell." That's what I would do to my brother. Like, motherfucker, get the fuck up off this kid now before I break your fucking head open in here. Like, you don't let somebody do that to a fucking helpless kid.
Yeah, so, of course, this is Harris County. And when we get somebody capital murder, they get capital murder. Mm-hmm. So,
He's going to the Polanski unit.
He's going to be one of the stars of the Polanski unit there in Livingston, Texas.
And he does, like, I don't believe in the death penalty, but.
You don't?
I don't believe in death penalty.
You want me? So we need to feed people for 20 years?
They need to fucking suffer.
And they're going to be suffering and doing.
I think they should do the same thing that they do to the other people.
Eye
for an eye.
Yeah. Painful. I actually execution is actually how you want humane.
Yeah, mercy.
It's control. It's control.
I don't like the
you don't suffer.
I feel like
they put you to sleep.
They put you to sleep before they do it.
Hey, but before they should execute you.
Yeah, what's the on
but
the green
like,
mile?
What if, like I feel like sometimes there's so many people on death row that may be innocent. You can inadvertently or accidentally kill somebody.
I had to write a story about this in my English class.
And you guys remember Carla Faye Tucker? My mom was in prison with her when she was younger. And she was such a sweet person. She was on drugs when she committed the act of murder. But she had, like, totally changed her life around. And then what do? You kill somebody like that?
What is her turning around going to do for the prison system? I mean, she did commit the crime.
Yeah.
She was judged by a jury of her peers,
but how can you when you say, "Oh, only God can judge somebody"? Like, it's not our place to decide.
Everybody,
you better than them if you kill them. Like, what makes you so much better?
Everybody goes to prison.
No, but you have to pay for what you
have to pay for.
That's what prison is. It's payment for what you did.
No,
you
that's not prison. Prison.
I don't think you should kill anybody. I don't believe in the death penalty. That's just me. I don't believe in it. Uh-oh. I don't think you should kill somebody for like. I don't think so.
Nikki don't believe in nothing.
Nikki.
No, I believe in beating a motherfucker within an inch of their life, but not totally taking their life.
We had this debate in class, in my English class, with Professor Henry. She was really good. So she had us to write a story about the death penalty. Do we believe in it? Just, you know, your own story, you make it up. And then she gave us, well, it was your mom that was on death row. It was your mom that was about to get. Do you believe now? You wouldn't. A lot of people change their minds.
I don't have to
a
know.
A lot.
What if that was her?
Was your child?
Didn't she use a pickaxe?
But look how young she was and what happened. Like, she was on drugs.
Could you imagine her standing over somebody actually?
But it's not like she made a conscious decision to do that.
I feel like if you commit murder by
to get drugs and
but nobody know. Like, when you don't know if you.
What about the Manson murders? Everybody he hung with was high off of something, and they killed the LaBianca woman and cut her baby out and all that. They didn't get the death penalty, but they should have. I mean, they tortured and murdered people that they didn't know because, hey, there's a house.
They didn't have shit else to do.
Let's go. And so if you don't have anything better to do with your time than to go and end somebody's life, why shouldn't we play with you and decide, you know what, let me pick June 5th and you're not going to be here anymore. How about that? I mean, it's the same thing.
I don't believe that a man, a woman, anybody should determine when your last day on earth is going
to
be.
Right. So if you do it to somebody else, it's only just that it get done back to you.
This is what I'm saying. Like, once you kill them, like, what do you say? If you feel like murder, if they were, their murder is
not murder. It's not murder.
It is. No, it's not. It's murder. If you take somebody's life, it's murder. It's either murder or self-defense. Those are the only two options. Killing some, that's, see what I'm saying? Society has made
us. So what do you tell the relatives?
Hey,
you
know what? If it's my relative, I'm sorry. If you're gonna
block, I'm sorry. Your mama's dead. I don't know what for.
Oh, no, you're going to die too.
I think she will really do it for real.
I mean, at that moment, you see them. You know,
you're there and you're in the spot and you can kill a motherfucker.
Yeah.
You exact your revenge or whatever. But like the death penalty, I feel like everybody make mistakes. So, if you go back to the no sin is bigger than the other.
Murder is not a mistake. Murder is not a mistake. If you take a a knife and you just stabbing a person, close and personal.
Every single one. But she was high. It's not like she was
high. I don't give a damn.
But this is what I'm saying. Have you ever been high on drugs?
Yes.
Well, probably not nothing that would you out of your mind. Let me tell you something. I'm going to tell you this because I came from a family with two parents that were on drugs. I don't mean like weed or cocaine. Heroin, fucking crack, stuff like that. I've seen my parents do things I know for sure they would never, ever do if they were sober. Because when you're on drugs, you are not in your right state of mind. So
I understand that.
But that's a choice they made to be taking the drugs.
Let me say this, Block. It is a choice that they made to take the drugs. But when you take certain drugs do take over your mind. I understand what she's saying when she say that, but I don't agree with her with the death penalty. I have an uncle that was murdered, senselessly murdered behind.
I have family
nothing.
Members like that too. I have family
and
members that was senselessly
I feel
murdered.
Like
people
these
I know.
Motherfuckers should be. You should be murdered too. Who are you to determine when my uncle or last day on earth gonna be?
Yeah.
That bothered. That pissed me off. That bothered me.
Cause so what did that fit
it
in
didn't
with
just
y'all,
murder. Because it didn't.
With y'all God and what y'all believe.
We're not talking about God right now.
No. But I'm asking, what does that fit in with that?
God that fits in with an eye for an eye.
So we go back to this, but y'all go by the Bible. That's in the Bible. See how the Bible is so contradictory of itself? Thou shalt not kill, but eye for eye. See what I'm saying? Bam.
So damn, Nikki.
Am I right? Am I right?
We ain't on that topic. No,
but
damn.
No, right or wrong.
She's
right or wrong.
Make this be
no. Right or wrong. Right or wrong.
Nah, you're right. Either you're right. I'm not going by the Bible. I'm just going by what I
is
think.
Is it contradictory
right.
or not?
We're not using the Bible to come up with
I understand
our decision.
What you're saying, but she just said,
so if you murder, the Bible says you should not murder. You shouldn't kill.
I'm not going to put my other cheek.
But then
when you kill, what are your consequences if you do?
You go to jail.
Yeah, you go to jail, yeah.
Who gonna pay for that?
I ain't got no money for the rest of your life.
Prison's a
property owner. You know, they
have cable attack. Prison's a property owner.
You got $5.
We're not paying for nothing. We're not paying for it because prison's are privately owned in Texas. So we don't pay for nothing. The consumers don't pay for people to go to prison.
TDC is owned. It's not
some
independent.
They are.
Okay, the state jail's right?
The state killers jail. Don't go to state jail. And you go to state jail, you can't get more than 2 years. Those are for first time and low offenders. State jail, you can't even get more than 2 years in state jail.
I can't believe the Texas Department of Justice is
a lot
some of them.
Owned.
Some
a lot of
them
prisons,
are.
A lot of prisons are privately
what
owned.
About the one in Alabama? What is that one?
I mean, I'm just saying, look, you can't be on both sides of the fence. Are you for eye for eye? Or are you for
I'm sorry. It depends.
Do you believe in the Ten Commandments or you believe in eye for eye? Which one is it?
It ain't no choice.
It's not. It's both. You can say thou shalt not kill. So this person is wrong. Oh, you wrong for killing because you're not supposed to kill. Mm-hmm. But kill him.
It's a case by case decision.
It won't be you, me, boss, or friend that's killing them. What that's they have to deal with their guard when it's time for them to deal with their guard.
If you're saying it's okay, you feel like that you're not doing it, so it's okay if you agreeing with it but not doing it. That's just like saying I don't. I didn't molest this kid.
I don't have a problem with Caitlyn Jenner, but I'm not going to choose to change my sexuality.
Well, that's because that's not your inner feeling.
Right. So I can't feel a certain way. I can't agree with, well, I don't have a problem with it, but I don't want to do it.
Right. I don't have to be the one administering it.
What that is, like it's right. That make you, that's what people use.
Some people feel like that. Some people feel like that it will make them feel better and bring closure if they
see. I don't know anybody.
I know a whole bunch of people that are witness to it.
Everybody I know that's seen some shit like that, got justice on the street or whatever, they always say, I thought it'd make me feel better, but it didn't.
So you rather be in life in prison?
Yeah, so a motherfucker can like repeatedly rape them, take their breakfast, shit like that. Don't kill them. You give them an easy way out. They don't even have to live with the shit they did. Motherfucker, no. It's like that lady, Carla Faye Tucker.
And then they get visits.
So that's when it get personal. Like, that's when it get personal. Like, I can't see my uncle anymore, but your mom can come down here and see you. You know what I'm saying? I can't touch my uncle.
Letters,
I can't
do anything.
Yeah,
you can get on Facebook.
So then I'm like
you can get a high school diploma if you don't have a college degree.
What Memphis from the Players Club? What did you say?
Hey, do something to make me feel better.
Oh, the moment that just became priest or something like that?
That's good.
Priest.
You don't
a whole bunch of them.
You feel like they shouldn't? They can't spread the word.
No.
This is what I'm saying.
Who are these people?
Didn't they just commit a sin that the Bible said, "Thou shalt not kill," or whatever?
But what's the point? But if you're going by the Bible, then where does repentance come in? Like, these people can't feel sorry or repent for what they did. Yeah. Only for small shit, not for killing people. Only if you steal a bubble gum or something, but not for killing people, you can't repent for that.
I believe that you can't repent.
And this is what I'm saying. Sometimes people do things.
And then you go do it again.
No. Sometimes people do things. It's nothing that I feel like people shouldn't be forgiven for.
Ooh.
Like when in terms of
baby fuckers.
No.
I know how you feel about that.
But it's my thing. People that do shit like that, it's not a matter of forgiving them or not.
What do you consider a baby fucker?
A fucking pedophile. If you
were talking about a pedophile. So basically, these five family members have gotten arrested, have steep bonds, and can't get out.
It's like 100-some thousand each, right?
Yeah. They don't got it if they paying somebody $25.
Look at them. You know they don't have it. Look at them.
But then we have the Duggars, whose son reportedly molested four of his sisters, and has not spent a second in jail. So what did you say about
money
Mr.
Talks.
Duggar?
That's
money
that
talks.
Long money.
That money, right? I mean, Nikki, can you agree? Do you see anything wrong with him experimenting with his sisters?
Well, I don't know the whole, I don't know how that was.
Is it ever okay?
Let me tell you, if you say, let me touch your boobs, and you let your sister be like, you can touch him, and you touch him, does it really make you a pedophile or you a curious kid who touched the boobs? Is it disgusting?
Get the shit out of the girls.
Yes.
Boobs. What the hell?
Is this? But nobody want them. Look at them. They wet as fuck. This is what I'm saying. Like,
see, my mind is going like.
Go buy you a doll.
What do you think? What do y'all think about that?
Get the Barbie doll.
But they're curious.
But don't touch your sister.
I don't know.
It's not okay. Why would you touch your sister's boobs?
Would you call the police and say, my son molested my kid? If your daughter say, my brother touched my boobs.
Well, if I don't.
I think I would have a talk with them.
Is what they did.
Okay.
That's what I'm saying.
What were the charges? What were they claiming?
He didn't have any charge. The charges
said he touched them over their clothes, touched their breasts over their clothes.
Okay, well, how many times did he do that?
Did he do it more than once? Well, hell yeah, he did it to four different girls.
Oh,
so he did
no,
it more than once.
Yeah.
So there.
But that's really
as
a parent.
Hold on. I'm going to tell you what that makes you. As a parent, you should look at your child and say, something is not quite right.
And that's what
Let's get this boy some help right now before it goes too far.
Because I got 19 damn kids and counting. Jesus. I'm supposed to lose all of them in CPS.
First of all, baby, she's too busy trying to keep that cat off the floor if you didn't push 19 kids out of it. Second of all, Oh, wow. How much, if I was her kids, when she got to like 10, her kids should have held her down and gave her a hysterectomy in the bathroom. Fuck you doing 19
10.
She went for number 20, but it wasn't
successful. It knew better. That kid was like, don't bring me into this bullshit. This kid was like, you're not going to bring me into this situation.
People don't have children like that.
Well,
no more.
That kid was like, hey, grandma.
It's ridiculous.
That's what I'm saying. This is like the 17th century. You can have 19
kids. My grandmother had 14 children.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
Nobody else.
If everybody still lived on plantations or farms or whatever, you had like 12, if you had acres to keep these motherfucking kids on.
We ain't had no damn acres. My grandmother had 14 children. Out of them 14
in a three-bedroom house.
Probably 10 of them lived with her in a three-bedroom house, plus they goddamn kids. Wow. We had bunk beds everywhere in the living room and everything. That's how we lived.
Farm living. Farm living.
And we ate good every day.
Because all people cook, let me tell you something.
Well, yeah. Anyway, this type of behavior was a contradiction, considering that the Duggars were considered a very religious, milk and honey kind of, you know, cream color kind of family. So basically, when this came to light, I think he's in the church. He's active in the church now. So when this came to light,
you gotta get active.
Man, you can't be. I'm gonna tell you, they do need to get some help for him. You cannot be like a sister titty toucher and leave my church. You can't do that.
That's what I said. Can you have a handful of titty and cat, and then we still watch you? What channel they're on? Were they on A&E?
I have never seen one of their shows.
Okay, well, they got dropped like hot potatoes, just like Kitty Boo Boo, Boo Boo Kitty. What was the little girl?
That was fucking disgusting what her mama did. That's why.
Shit, it won't come to me.
Okay, well, anyway.
I know you're talking
honey
about
Honey Boo Boo.
Honey Boo Boo.
That was disgusting what her mama did.
You okay, and I feel like what he did was disgusting. She dated a person.
I mean, her boyfriend molested her daughter, and then when he got out of jail, she took him back.
Yeah. So, again, here we go. Again, that was somebody rich. I mean, eventually ended up rich. And
well,
they had
he went pedophilia. To jail, though. He, did
he went to jail, but then once she, just like you said, she tried to take him back. You know, somebody should have reported her for that because she still had a minor in the house.
Well, she didn't really have many options in the man department.
Ooh, no.
Why should they keep running down? Oh, no, why should they keep sugar bath?
She could have kept sugar bath. He wanted her. He loved her.
I don't know.
And then
well, she only had two options.
here we go. We talk about Mr. Kelly. Mr. Kelly. So he marries an underage child. We say, you know what? You done fucked up. Don't do this no more. Then he's seen in a video. I mean, a porno. With a child that's obviously underage and is charged. How come he served no time in jail?
Because he's a rich, money talented. When that money is long, it holds long conversations, and society sometimes just seem to overlook or forget things that you ever did.
And then
he was in California too, right?
I don't know where he was when it happened.
Yeah, California, they let you go, whatever.
But this is my thing. Like, I could see if it was just the videos, but R. Kelly, like, when he went to court, it was specifically because they found child pornography on his computer, on his hard drive. Like, he's clearly a fucking pedophile. So, you women throwing your panties at him, and these babies that y'all making to his music, he just want to fuck them like y'all crazy. It's ridiculous that y'all are just doing this shit. Like, people keep paying to go to the concerts. Y'all, like, supporting this man. Yeah, motherfucker down the street, look at your daughter wrong. You want to bust his fucking head open. This grown ass man married a child.
Let me tell you how. I'm going to just say this. Not my beliefs, just simply saying. But if R. Kelly do it, we can sue him and we can get all this money and then we're going to be good.
But. What you're saying, I understand what you're saying. Okay. Because.
They'll sacrifice
but,
it.
Yeah, but what Illuminati. Is. But what is
we gotta have to talk about that whole nother we gotta talk about that one day because I have a whole thing on that.
But what is the trend with all of these old ass men picking up? Oh, I'm sorry, did I say men and women picking up these little young things, risking their freedom.
How old and how young?
I'm saying these, I mean, just recently, this teacher, I think he
here
was
in
at,
Houston.
Yeah, here in Houston, teacher.
Cypress or somewhere, Katie or something.
Where was he working at? Like a gymnastic place?
Mm-hmm.
Was accused of having sex with an underage employee of the business. First of all,
so she was probably 16.
Yeah, underage means 14 to 16.
Well, this is my thing.
To be able to work, I say that's why I said
now, when
16.
I was 15 or 16, even mm-hmm. though a man probably, I knew right from wrong, a man could not sway me to have sex or nothing like that. If I was going to have sex with somebody and they were like older than me, I was making a conscious decision to do so. It's not like they slicked me into it or tricked me or talked me into it. It was something, I mean, nobody was, I was not like, oh, I don't know. And he was like, yes, baby, do it. It's going to feel so good. It was like, shit,
you
I'm coming around now.
In Texas.
We're going to Bennigan's. And I'm right. probably about to go do this. I mean, I was a teenager. So shit like that just happens. Like when I was 16 or 15, I had a boyfriend that was like 18. I did. And when I was like 16, I was into guys that were older than me.
No, ma'am.
That was me. My mama didn't, you know.
No, she didn't know because in Texas, you under the age of 17, you cannot give consent for any type
by
of
law.
Sexual.
But you know how you know okay, these girls are gonna say, you know.
Okay,
say
but yes. The dude is still going to jail because you cannot give consent. You cannot give consent, and then when your mom and your daddy, the mom and the daddy find out, hell, he good as dead anyway. So the body,
it depends on.
So
it
where do you draw the line between statutory rape and molestation? Like, what do you think is the difference?
I think statutory rape is
just the actual act.
I think it's the act of doing it. Like, we know you didn't really rape her, but.
That's
she
right.
wasn't of age, so okay. you shouldn't have
your
sex
bag.
With her.
Yeah,
so we're not going to charge you with rape, per se.
But see, this is, I knew a guy when I was in high school. We were in middle school. He was older than us. The girl living next door to us was his girlfriend. He was like probably like 19. She was in high school. 18 or 19, something like that. So he had already been convicted of statutory rape before. And she was like, oh, it's just statutory rape. You know, she was like, she was cool with it or whatever. So fast forward to like a few years later, she had a little sister. Her little sister was 4 or 5. Their mom died. Well, their mom didn't die until afterwards. This happened. The sister, the little baby, she kept complaining. They took her to the doctor. He had raped her and given her gave her STD. She was only like 4 or 5.
I remember that.
She was young.
I remember.
They stayed next door to us when we stayed in Southport.
Okay.
We were young. We were in middle school. We didn't think anything of. We never reported him or anything. He would come and knock on the window and chit-chat with me and my cousin. My cousin was a year younger than me. My cousin, even we were in middle school, she had real big, you know. So he would come and hang out with all of us in the neighborhood. We just all like hung out on the block or whatever, on the street. And I guess as kids, you never think, oh, like you always say, like, it was statutory rape. You're like, oh, he just had a girlfriend. He was older than her. But come to find out, he was a nasty fucker because he raped his little sister. I mean, he raped the girl's little sister and gave her something. And the sister knew about it and hid it from the mom. Stressed the mom out so bad. She died like a couple of months later.
What?
Like, and she wasn't sick before that. Like, yeah, she wound up dying.
Wow.
From stress. From, you stress know, because they took her from her. But the sister knew that. Knew about
had
it.
Had he ever tried to come on to you or your cousin?
Yeah, he did. But we were just like, he's nasty. He's too old for that. And we just kept it pushing. Like, we never said anything. But, like, it always make you think in hindsight, should you have said something? And it could have been this situation.
That's
been
a pedophile. Because a pedophile,
yeah, that's
a pedophile.
Actually
a pedophile.
He's a predator.
Right.
He's a predator. He goes after. That's what he's looking for. It's like a hunt.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a hide.
Baby, don't come this way. Don't do that. But we had this discussion the other day about the death penalty, and this guy was saying, oh, well, you know, that people should be put to death for that. And I was like, oh, well, no. So then my son gonna break out in the middle of the conversation and say, but mama, you said you would kill somebody if you caught him messing with us. So that's the death penalty. But I do feel like that. That's what made me rethink. When he said that, I was like, well, I would. If I caught a motherfucker on my kids, I'm trying to crack your shit open, and I'm not even lying.
Well, did y'all see the lady? I think this happened a couple of years ago. She found out that her husband was raping her daughter. So she set him on fire and burnt him up.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
That sounds about right.
To do that.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Because I feel like you're making a nasty ass conscious decision.
But they charging her too.
Because well, they have to, but ain't nobody gonna get.
So do you think pedophilia charge. Is a mental thing?
I do.
I think they born.
Yeah, I do.
They are born. You born a pedophile?
Huh? So you saying that Michael Jackson was a born pedophile?
Yeah, because people, you born with whoever your sexual attraction to. If you gay, you born with a sexual attraction to the opposite, to the same sex. If you straight, you born with a sexual attraction to the opposite sex. What did I say the same thing twice?
No, you got it
okay.
right.
Okay, so if you're a pedophile, you are born with a sexual attraction to children. You are. Yeah. You born like that. It's disgusting. It's just like psychos are born with the want to kill. So... That's what they were saying, that they try to rehab sex offenders instead of, and it was a whole thing recently about putting them in rehab as opposed to jail.
So why do you think so many people let their children around Michael Jackson when it was like common knowledge?
Do you want to take this one?
What?
I'm just saying.
You have said like that kid money just loan.
No, I'm just saying. We've been talking about money, the money loan.
I mean, the money may be long, but I can see weirdo from a mile away.
So the money is long. Michael Jackson to be in the presence of Michael Jackson. Okay. Who else can
or
say that?
Okay, hold up, boss. Let him do it, like you said. Let him do it, and then try.
Y'all have Michael Jackson over here for an interview in Skylab Studios, okay. And he says, "Ooh, whose kid is that?"
None of your goddamn business.
I got you, Mike. Can Mikey come over and play?
Now you're too old.
So, I mean, that's what I'm saying. What parent would have just let? I'll be like, Mike, shut the fuck up. No, you're not taking my kid nowhere. Yeah, it was nice to meet you.
What you came here for? And okay. This ain't what you want to leave with.
Okay. And even in his death, his estate is being sued. His estate is being sued for damages due to a molestation accusation.
Oh, he was.
This is okay with the Michael Jackson thing. I'm just really like, at one point I felt like he was so eccentric that people kind of said that, and then it kind of, you know.
Do you think Michael Jackson was a pedophile?
I don't know. I don't know if he really molested
kids. I think Michael Jackson was traumatized mentally from all the abuse.
I think he just was not mentally as adult as he should have been
at all.
Now, do I?
So
I don't
does
know.
It
if
not
he
make
really,
it a crime.
Well, I don't know. I don't know if he touched the kids. That's the whole thing.
I mean, how many kids? Okay, I was.
When you famous,
morning.
It only take one person to say something, and then everybody gonna, you know, people gonna jump on the bandwagon.
Mm-hmm. Hold on. I was listening to another show this morning, and there was a guy that came on who talked about being abused as a young boy and how much it traumatized him, and how when he went to go tell his mother about this close family member that was touching him, he wasn't just touching him, he was penetrating everything. Mm-hmm. Okay. And so when he went to go tell his mother did not believe him. He said that just hurt him to his heart. So basically he says that when a child that young comes to you and tell you somebody been doing this and that to them, that you should believe them. No kid wakes up in the morning and says, okay, I think I'm gonna say this morning that he touched mine and did this and did that. No kid, I believe, would make up.
I don't think the
story.
Kids did make it up. I think the parents made it up and then fed it to the kids with Michael Jackson. I feel like they kind of
all those scenarios.
I feel like what they did was, I feel like people see certain things and take advantage. Like, this is my thing. If you've seen this on TV already, why would you send your kid there with him? And then all of a sudden, oh my God, I didn't think he would do it, but he touched my kid.
So it was copycats.
That's what I feel like.
It was real like with Bill Cosby and then a bunch people, of copycats.
Like with Bill Cosby, all these people came out, then all of a sudden, some lady, this lady out the blue, months after everybody else. Oh well, you know, I was with him recently, and he did the same thing. This is somebody who's trying to get on the bandwagon with other people. Like I just feel like I don't know with Michael Jackson, like, but I wasn't there. In my mind, did I really feel like he was a pedophile? I never really looked at. Would I what?
If he was alive,
no, just as a precautionary measure, I wouldn't. Because exactly. I wouldn't leave my child with any man I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't even leave my kids with. I rarely leave my kids with men. Period. Like my son, he yeah, but my daughter, no. My daughter goes to dad and me, and she doesn't go anywhere with any other man except their shepherd. And she never goes by herself. It's always both of my kids together. So, no, my kid's not going anywhere. I mean, you're not doing that. That's just how that is. But I don't know with that. I don't know. I don't feel in my heart like, oh, but because we don't have him on tape like R. Kelly, like, you on tape and you pissing on his kid. Now, there were two women on the videotape. One of them was grown. One of them was a child. But you clearly have exhibited a like for children in the fact that you met. Now, with Michael Jackson, it was all just, oh, my child said he touched me like this. Nobody ever saw him, like, with the kid or do anything. And why y'all keep sending y'all kids there if you feel like that? I know better than let my fucking child go to R. Kelly house. Like, wow. Motherfucker, I look 12. You can't even look at me too hard. That's how I feel about that.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. So how old do you think it is or age appropriate to talk to your kids about somebody touching them?
Oh, look, you, as soon as your child is like it. I don't know. I would say, yeah, as soon as they're old enough, you ask them, has anybody ever touched you this way? Because you want to instill that in them early. Right. You want to instill it in them early. Mm-hmm. Don't let nobody do this. And I'm going to tell you, my daughter, I'm always on her because she's only 9, but she got a little bush going on. So I'm always wanting to know the hell.
That's right.
But
that's
she's
right.
Always been like, well, she has hair on her legs and arms and stuff like that. So mm-hmm. I'm just, look, all the time. Somebody touch it, like I want to know. Like if you know if somebody this is the places people are not supposed to touch.
Yeah, very good.
So that's how I do that. Very my son, good. You can't, baby. You can't even look at him too hard. He like, well, what is he looking at? So
well, on a brighter note, ooh, that was painful. Nikki and Latasha, mm-hmm. Do y'all know that we're the flavor of the month for billionaires?
Woo woo!
By time.
Oh well, Blanca, you already married Mike.
I'm left out all.
Fuck for life.
Yeah, there was an article that brought to attention that more and more everyday billionaires are dating black women.
Good, because I love billionaires, so we go right together. We go right together.
While thousandaire athletes choose to date outside their race, other races, mm-hmm. Besides black, billionaires are dating women of color. And so, for example, we have Janet Jackson. Janet Jackson just
recently. Did you see her picture?
Yeah.
Baby. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Janet Jackson married her a billionaire.
Mm-hmm. Eve.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Eve married a cream color fella. George Lucas.
With some billions.
George Lucas, whose reported net worth is $3.9 billion, has a black girlfriend.
She is on top of that Star Trek.
Mm-hmm. No. And oh, I forgot to mention Janet Jackson's husband. I can't even say his name. He's worth $4.5 billion. Supermodel Naomi Campbell. She's married to Russian billionaire tycoon Vladimir. I can't say his last name either. It don't show his net worth, so he must be filthy, filthy rich. Peter Norton of Norton Securities, the man that makes
the antivirus
mm-hmm. He got him a sister on his arm.
There is hope, Nikki. Oh, we ain't gonna get us no rapper or no
football. What the hell I want with one of them?
You don't want one of them when there's a billionaire out there waiting on you, okay? There's a billionaire out there waiting on you. So, ladies, don't give up. Sit tight. Oh, Robert De Niro.
Be patient.
He's not quite a billionaire, but he's worth $185
million. I don't want y'all light skinned asses, though.
That's a nice amount.
That's enough.
Okay.
I'll take that.
It's almost a billion. Almost a billionaire.
The money.
So have faith, ladies. Start, you know, hooking. What do you know? What do you call it? No, I'm not saying hooking. that smoking shit, whatever.
Hookah.
Okay.
That's a whole different profession.
Start. start hanging out at the Starbucks and maybe you'll run into your Prince Charming.
But that article did say not just any black woman. You have to be intelligent.
Oh, I forgot.
Please add that in there.
They don't want no bimbos.
So what they don't want no bitches with no bundles either, because none of them got women with bundles hand.
Wait a minute.
You know what she's
talking about. Oh, you know what? You all right. I know. Now, Janet got some skills made. Janet's got some
sometimes. No, did you see the picture? Did you see the picture with the suspenders? That was all real hair.
But she going to have some
a lot of natural black women.
Right. There's some ordinary black
sisters. I got your bundles was over there on fleek. I'm sorry.
I'm like, what? I can't do
they
that.
They want these bitches with these bundles. They want you to look like Lupita Nyong'o.
That's right.
What's the Sudanese? Alec Wick. They want you to look like her. You know what I'm talking about?
Know
her. You know the really dark model.
She used to be a runway model.
She's Sudanese.
Oh, yes, I do. Like
yeah. Okay.
Well, I guess I'll go get my hair cut. What time?
All right, ladies. It's that time again. It's time for us to say our goodbyes. So, but before we do that, guess what? We have a watch alert because this weekend, the new episode, the second season of Power begins. So make sure you guys watch it. Because we're going to try to do a video blog.
We're going
to
have two shows then, right? Because we're not doing a show next week.
Okay. Oh, and also, we're not going to be doing a show next week. Okay. So we're going to be gone. We're going to be gone on a little vacay. We're not going to be here next Thursday, but the following Thursday, we will be back. So
I'm going to give y'all my login information. You download the Stars app.
So, they're having a sidebar on us. So we're going to miss a Thursday, but we'll be back the following Thursday. And also another watch alert. Orange is the New Black.
Oh, yes.
Starts June 12th.
Yeah.
On Netflix. That's my show. That's my shit. So anybody want to give any goodbye shout outs?
Well, I want to give a shout out to my boo Keith. He's listening.
Nikki got a boo.
He told me I need to say my boo.
Hey, boo.
And everyone else that's listening.
Cameras.
And everyone that's listening, thank you guys.
I cut this short.
Okay, anybody else?
So all the listeners and the our live crew that's here.
Our live is yeah. Melinda, Wally, Michelle, and DJ Fluffy. Okay. Well, I guess that's gonna be a wrap for us.
Oh wait, shout out to Mike Guns. He got him out.
look at him on the webcam, y'all. Okay. Well, we're gonna say goodbye to everybody. Love, peace, hair grease. We'll see you not this Thursday, but next Thursday on LypStk Live. Mwah!
This is your boy, Light Jockey Mike, and I just wanted to thank you for supporting SCP Radio. That's the end of our show, but please be sure to check us out on spacecadetpro.com, where you will be able to watch our videos, find and like all of our social media accounts, and chat with us. While you are there, click on the radio tab, where you will be able to see the show schedule and all of the different ways to reach us. You can also listen to us from there if you are on a PC or laptop. Thanks again, and remember, we are the future in entertainment.